Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In our last video, we have seen how to set up AEM author and publish instances with a shared S3 data store. In this video, let us see how to set up AEM author and publish instances with Azure storage services. Azure storage services can be used for individual instances or multiple instances sharing the same service. Let us see how to configure AEM author and publish instances with a shared Azure storage services. Additional publish instances can be added to share the same data store by following the same steps. For demo purpose, we are going with only one author and publish instance, but you can add multiple instances to share the same storage service. I am going to set up the data store with new instances, but the same can be configured for existing instances also. Maybe additional step is required to migrate the existing binary data from the local system to the Azure storage service. So maybe we can use the CRX to work tool to migrate the local store binary to Azure data store. As a first step, we need to configure the Azure storage service. For that, let me log into the Azure portal. I'm using the free trial access. So log into the portal, click on storage accounts. I'm just clicking add here. Create. So here resource group, so you can create new or you can select the existing one. I'm going with the existing one. Then I need to put a storage account name here. Maybe I will put AEM repository. The performance, you can keep it the same standard. Then account kind, you can go with the storage v2. So this is the basic storage account type for blobs, files, queues and table. So anyway, we are going with blobs, so this type is fine. Then remaining replication I am leaving like that. Then access tier I am leaving to default hot. Click on next. Yeah, I am not going to create change anything here. So then tags is fine. Create. Yeah, validate. Click on create. Okay, this is fine now. Storage account is completed. So it may take another 2-3 seconds or maybe minute. So, but we can proceed. Let us now set up the author instance. So, let me go here. So I already created a folder under Azure like author and publisher. Okay, so as a first step, let me unpack this. That is completed. The next step, we need to download this Azure blob connector and configure it. So it can be downloaded from this particular URL. So 1.6.3 is the latest version. You can download from here. I have already downloaded and extracted. So let me go to that. From here, go into JCR root libs system, install. Copy this install folder. Install folder will have all the required jar file 1 and 15 folder. So if you go inside, this cloud Azure, all those jar files are here. Just copy this. Go into this author folder. Put it here. Now go back here under config. There is a two configuration. Copy this. So data store and this one. Go under this install folder and put it. Now we need to do this Azure data store configuration. For that, go here. But this is all only default configuration. I am going to add some additional configurations here. Okay, maybe let me remove this. We can copy it again. Okay, this is the configuration. We need to configure some of the value here. One first one is Azure blob endpoint. So for that, again go back to this console, Azure console. So now the deployment is completed. Go to resources. Here, if you come here, you will be able to see the properties. Click on the properties. If you come here, the primary blob service endpoint. Just copy this next one is this authentication. So the authentication can happen in two ways. One is through this access key and secret key. Another one is through Azure SAS. It's a like a means like it's a shared access signature. So it's a kind of string. It will contain the secret security token that can be appended like in the URL whenever we invoke this Azure storage service operations. The security token will be encapsulated with the permissions and also the interval of access. So this will support 1.6.3 connector supports both this option Azure SAS and access key secret key based authentication. So one more thing is like if this value, both the values are there, this Azure SAS will take the priority and this access key and secret key will be ignored. So I will be for demo purpose anyway, I will go with access key and secret key, but anything is fine, but I will show how to this generate this access key. Okay, I will go here back. So I will show you how to generate this access key. See, you can click on this it's a SAS, click on this shared access signature. Whatever the allowed services, resource type, permissions and all those things, then the validity, then finally select this signing key. There is a two keys are available, you can select one, then generate the SAS. So this will generate a connection SAS string, and then you can copy that. Well, maybe I will show you that, just to generate it. Yeah, this SAS token, copy this value and you have to keep it in the SAS. So here, like wherever the equals comes in, it should be escaped with the backslash. So that is one additional step. Okay, let me show you now how to go with the access token. For that, go to access keys. Yeah, here if you see the storage account name, copy this. This is going to be our access key. Paste it in the access key. Now key, either key 1 or key 2, either one you can copy. So I copied the key 1. Now here again same thing, the equal should be escaped. Now the container name, you can keep any container name. So there is again two options to create this container. So you can go and create a container from here. So before starting before starting the server. So if you go into blobs, so here you can create a container. So whatever the name. Another option is just to go and keep a name, required name here. So automatically the container will be created by this connector. Now I am going with the max connection 40, retry count, circuit timeout, upload threads 20. Writer threads, then there is another some configuration here. So another one is a secret. So this this value is same even in the S3 data store. So if, this property is not mandatory for individual instances, but if you are going to have a shared instances, this value should be kept. Also this value can be any random value, but it should be unique across all the instances. So they are going to share the same storage service. Okay, so we completed this configuration. Now what we need to do is like let's start the server. So I will go here. Okay, go back. Okay, enter the admin password. Okay, fine. Now if you go to this CRX start, here another folder will be created. With the name repository. Under the repository you will have another repository with the data store. So data store will, under data store all the required cached folder will be created. I will explain that once. Also like keep monitor the log. So once everything is fine here, there is a container will be created, and under that container all this blob data will be uploaded. But I think it will take some time, so let's wait for that. So it may take some time, so then we can proceed. Okay, now the repository folder is created. If you go inside, yeah, there is a segment store, index, blob IDs. Again, one more folder repository, go inside that, data store. You will have download, upload term. This is a cache folder for the data store. This will help us to improve the performance. So the system will not directly access from the Azure data store. Instead of that, it will be cached in the system, in the local system. So upload folder for upload and download for download. So if you see here, yeah, so the download is still progress. So at the end you should be seeing around 255 folders here. So same way, if you go to upload, so upload is in progress. Yeah, 255 items needs to be uploaded. So it's still the upload is progress. So once the upload is completed, you will be seeing this folder will be emptied with zero folders. So this upload will, system is getting started now, server, but this upload is asynchronous, it will have in background. Better to wait until this upload is completed so that we can next proceed with the publisher. So meanwhile, let me show you this container might have got created now. Yeah, the shared container is created. Okay, it's getting uploaded. So let's wait this upload and download to complete, then we can proceed with the next part. Okay, still the download and upload is going on. So if you see download, still it is 96. We go to down upload, yeah. Upload is showing 256, maybe it will take time. So meanwhile we can monitor the log. If you see here, yeah, upload staging cache successfully added. So yeah, finished removal of 18 files, means like whatever is completed uploading, these files will get removed. So yeah, still it's going to take time. Let's wait. Okay, the upload is completed now. Let's look into that. Seeker repository data store. First let us check into the download. So if you see now it's a 256 items, so all these binaries are downloaded. Now I will go to upload. Yeah, if you see this folder is empty, so it means all this required binaries are uploaded into Azure data store. So yeah, this step is completed. Now let's quickly go and check the URLs. Okay, this index.jsp looking fine. AEM start, maybe I will go to assets files. Yeah, so let me go into some of the pages. Yeah, so let me open up the asset. Okay, looking fine. Okay, this conclude the author setup. Now what we will do is like let us start setting up the publisher. So publisher, the steps are going to be same. There is no not much different. So it's going to point to the same shared data store. Okay, let us do that. So for that, I have a folder again, same thing with publish. So let me first unpack this. Okay, completed. Let me go back. Now the configurations are same. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this install folder from here and I'm going to paste it in the publish. Okay, now the next step, we need to start the server. This is the command to start the server. So here if you see, like I am attaching this publish run mode additionally. So we'll go and execute this command. Enter the admin password. Okay. Now again same thing. So this will create a repository folder here and sync up this binary with this data store, because we are using the shared one. So it will not upload much, maybe some delta. So otherwise it will try to sync up with the Azure data store. So let's wait for that. It's going to take some time. So once publisher also ready, we need to create some binary less default agent in author, so that it will help us to replicate the content from author to publisher. We are to use the binary less. Why? Because we are not going to replicate the content as such. So just we are going to replicate the metadata, and the servers are going to point to the same data store.
Okay, now if you see this repository data store folder is created, there is a same way download and upload. So now if I go inside download, yeah, 57 items. If I go to upload, 59 items. So we need to wait for some more time so that this upload folder will be emptied. So it means all the sync up will be completed, and also this download folder is going to have around 256 folders. Okay. Some files are getting uploaded. So if I go to download, all are downloaded. If I go to upload, still some files are uploaded. I'm not sure if there is any error, maybe, or my network may be slow. So let us continue. Maybe already the server is started. Let me go into the, yeah, the server is started. Now this conclude the configuration of publisher server. Now the next step is we need to configure a binary less replication agent. For that, go inside author server. I will go into the admin. Okay, go inside replication agents on author. So I'm not going to create new agent. Anyway, I will edit the existing agent. Okay, now click on edit. Okay, here change the serialization type to binary less. Then one more thing, you need to change the URL. You need to add another query parameter, binary less equal to true. Okay, that is a change. Click on OK. This is fine. Now maybe let me click on view log. So let me add one, upload one new image. Close this. Let me go here under this, create files. Okay, I will go with this image. Okay, this thumbnail, upload. Okay, this image is uploaded. Now let me open and see. Okay, it's fine. I had published it, so I have to publish. Okay, close. If I go here, yeah, now it's fine. Now let me log into publisher now. Okay, now let me go into the start.html assets files. Okay, let me copy this part here. Okay, the image is loading now, so the replication is success. Okay, this concludes the setup of AEM author and publish instance with the shared Azure storage service. Okay, thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.